give you an example of somebody that's flown in the pathetic, how they float. They'll tell you something that everybody already know. Play something soft and meditational. I know the word is meditational, but I'm flown in the pathetic. I'm going to act like I'm deep, but I'm really not. They look at you and tell everybody something we already know. They say, you know what? This just came in my spirit. And they always have to, gotta have that look like something stink in the room. They be like, And then they say something that everybody already know. And then they act like everybody should be slain. They say this, they be like, hallelujah. The Lord just told me to tell you, tomorrow is Friday.
Each day, each week, each month, each year, the world is falling further away from a true intimate relationship with God. According to the National Congregation Study, there are well over 400,000 churches in the United States, with an estimated upwards of 60 to 70 million members total.
Where have you been, Mr. Underwood? And I noticed on the calendar I'm supposed to marry y'all. What makes you think I'd marry you? You're one of the sorriest church members I have. You're not worth 15 cents.
Now, do y'all really think that a nation that gives two craps about Jesus Christ and the Word of God in its truest form would allow 400,000 facilities to go up that would lead people to Jesus in its truest form?
All right, so you need to lose weight. Find a good bra. You need to go to Intimates. It's called Intimates. I took my wife. My wife knew nothing about anything. Because she came from a family who didn't know anything about anything. I took my wife to a place that they have. We don't buy bras at Victoria. Not black women that got large breasts. So you need to get your bra made.
The only way you can separate the church from the state truly is when you get a personal relationship with the Father and you are truly led by the Holy Spirit. Some people go to church just to say they went. Some people go because they feel they are balancing out the evil and good they've done in their lives. Some people go to be nosy.
Hey, sir, what you talking over here? Hey! What you talking? I'm talking to you, sir. Thank you. God bless you. I'm preaching.
But who really goes these days to be purified by the Spirit? Who really goes to drop all and follow Christ? Who really goes to hear the truth, unadulterated, unfiltered, no matter how much it hurts?
I know that my posts about my soulful Sundays, which are held here in my gymnasium here at the church, it's upsetting some of you traditional church folk Oh, Lord, he gone to hell. Why are they doing that in the church? Why is it with your fake, phony asses that you believe that because you love God that you cannot enjoy life?
1 Corinthians 12 and 27 tells us that we are the body of Christ, individually, yet a whole. And Colossians 1:18 goes on to tell us that the body is the church. See, the problem is so many people are focused on waiting on a set day to go to church when every day you should spiritually reside in the church. A church that is not made by hands. A church that is scattered in the earth but is seen collectively in God's eyes. A church that is only signified by the body and not by a lackluster creative sign on the highway. If your pastor signed off on a 501c3, then your church is now an artificial person, documented, subject to the state, created by the state for the benefit of the public, not the benefit of the Lord Jesus Christ. And they're granted privileges by the state at their discretion. Or in other words, you no longer serve the God of the Bible, despite what you claim to believe. They are basically signing a contract saying they will obey men over God. Contracts are not just something you scribble your name on. They are your binding word, meaning that you have given your word to do and abide by everything listed out in that contract.
It's called a contract.
You want us to sign this?
Just a formality, really. Yeah.
Who are they?
Okay, they're my lawyers. Liability issues, litigious society, frivolous lawsuits, you understand. Basically, this contract guarantees you can have all the fun you want and nothing bad's ever gonna happen.
The ADF, which is Alliance Defending Freedom, has silenced churches via the IRS from talking about certain situations and issues in the pulpit, especially political views. This was put into effect around 1954. Instead of fearing the Lord God, who is the beginning of wisdom and understanding, pastors choose to fear losing their tax-exempt status.
So where does the number 2,844,000 come from on your asset liability?
That's, I guess, the appraisal value of the home or the residential center.
Is it a home?
No, it's a residential center. We use it.
All right, so you're saying it's not something you own, but you have it listed as an asset of $2.8 million.
That's probably a mistake. Like I say, it probably should be a liability.
To this day, I still hear preachers make excuses and say they are only silenced on political matters. Man, they silenced on a lot of things, y'all. They rarely touch on tithes and offerings in the right manner, fornication, idol worship, adultery, this wicked government. But why? It's because through binding contract, they are prohibited.
And people do church the same way. They pay for where the music is nice, where they got the smoke coming out of the stage, and then now they cut the lights off in church. It is a theater.
Amen.
You don't believe it? Where do you think theater comes from? The prefix the is God, like theology. So you have theology, you have theater. Church is the God show.
If you are so-called called by God and you keep quiet on these matters, you are in violation against scripture concerning the church. Why are there filthy rich pastors with struggling members? Check this out. If these 400,000 facilities were of God, then why is the U.S. still headed towards destruction? The Holy Spirit is powerful and life-changing. So why don't we see a plethora of spiritual movers and shakers out here? It's because the facilities of spiritual stagnation are getting them to a certain place and keeping them there. John chapter 10 speaks about hirelings who are doing it for the money, and when things get rough, they will leave the sheep and the sheep will scatter. Kind of what Kevin Wesley did.
Why would God even need to do all that in the first place to free Israelites? If he wanted to set them free, he could have just did it, right? He didn't have to part the Red Sea. He didn't have to send plagues. He didn't even have to send Moses. He didn't have to use a burning bush. He did not have to turn water into blood. He didn't have to do any of this stuff, right? But he did. It's literature, it's stories, it's allegory. An all intelligent being would not do that. Trust me.
He was a wolf in sheep clothing the entire time. A person called by God will speak truth pertaining to scripture with no compromise.
Yeah, this man was money hungry. He was after money because he came in spending money ridiculously. He was a manipulator. He was cunning.
I think they have a lot of preachers using the church for personal gain.
We ask questions
regarding finances, and it was told to us, take what I give you, or you don't like what I'm giving you, go back where you came from.
In the four-walled church I used to attend when I was younger, I knew it was spiritually dead when they started making the youth watch Tyler Perry movies for spiritual insight.